That's rolling, isn't it?
Colin started coming to my house, and we tried to record a couple times, and just wasn't, like, you know, nothing was really moving on it. And the first time we came here, it was you, me, and Nate. What I realized later, a lot of stuff down that day, and I realized how easy it is once you have, when the equipment's right, and Colin's good about just getting the stuff all set up and ready to go, and if you have no expectations of what's coming from it, you're not like trying to cut the next big album, you're trying to, you know, see what happens and what you get out of it. And a lot of times it's been pretty solid because we just keep recording almost everything we're doing. So the house is really cool too. So it's an old beat up house, but it's solid. I think even if I was standing there beside those cold steel rails, I'd still be holding on to my life.
Seeing the kind of groups that form every week, pretty interesting. Kind of groups. Some week we'd have two pianists, some week we'd have three, four guitarists, a couple bassists here and there, and we all announce. It's good to be with a group of musicians that can actually move up, sit in someone else's chair, play someone else's. It's been giving them a break. I don't know, it's been a cool experience just getting together, seeing what happens. Seeing her turn from shy, I'm just gonna play my stuff, to being able to sit on with people and actually keep up. Right.
When I was 20, I could never have hung out on the stage with, you know, these cats that she plays with. A couple days after I put the Memphis thing up, she was like, seriously, can I get that soprano chick out of my head? She's like, you know, y'all sound great, but Jesus.
And I don't believe in love. I like figuring out different things that they're already, but I'm just picking around to see where it's at. It's really cool. Yeah. He definitely helped me out and showed me what I needed to know that day. Just kind of took me under his wing.
I met her many, many, many lives ago. Her progress has been interesting because it's, you know, I've been able to watch it firsthand, you know, watch it sit together for 6 hours, finally, in her own mind, realize that she already knew what she was going to do. It's already there, you just gotta open up whatever channel you're living on. Five. No, she's come a long way. Long way to go. Long way to go.
I'd be really good at catching on.
Bad things about you, you know, you put it out. Okay, that's how it looks like, yeah, but you know, but then there's that face first. Do you see gray or do you see pink?
See a piano. I really do think about my life and what has happened.
We're all opening up something, you know, and it's a box for some people, it's a vault for others, you know, but we're going into everybody's world and saying, okay, what's in here?
The first time I played bass and sax, had no idea what key it was in. I didn't know the chord changes, I didn't really know what I was doing, and I was believing the fact that I didn't know what I was doing, so. I've learned that there is not a wrong key, and there is never a wrong note. When I play with cats, I feel like we have some sort of weird connection, but I think that something big is coming out of both of us.
You know, one of my favorite things about playing music with other people is that the more you do it, it's like you can almost like read their mind or something.
Second time I played it, Lige was there. Lige kind of just showed up.
When Lige came, I'd only met him like a time or two before.
I was sitting on the porch, it's gonna be Quinn and Brianna. And here comes a dude. I mean, I've seen him before, but I didn't remember where. And he just came up like an old friend.
Literally went the distance. He came like halfway across town on bike with a mandolin and a resonator, just a guitar resonator on his back.
Drenched in sweat, and I was just like, "You want a glass of water?" And you know, we all introduced each other.
That was the day I might not remember too much about.
I had seen him, really just heard him, and then I finally got to see him.
He surprised me.
It like feeds off the dynamics of the song.
Who are we listening? Who are we following? And Lige's, he's got a really good handle on all that, so he's a really strong person to help.
Music is my passion. Music, if I couldn't play music, I don't know what I'd do.
Big inspiration. Big inspiration. live now.
She rocked me to my soul. She rocked me to my soul.
You guys got something.
For sure.
Buried in time.
She's a strutter, she can shake it some. Oh man, look at her run. She's a strutter, she can shake it some. Oh man, look at her run. Run, run, run. She rocked me to my soul. She rocked me to my soul. She rocked me to my soul. She rocked me to my soul.
I'm looking forward to it. Back.
What's he coming back? Is he gonna go?
Yeah, he's coming back to the hall. Like that, it's a bunch of songwriters that come together and they're all great singer-songwriters by themselves, but they come together and they all know their instruments and they can all play together really well. Just really like that.
You see my baby like a honey pot. Oh, and that pot is hot. You see my baby like a honey pot.
I'm excited to see everybody really progress. I want everybody to come here and become the player that you wanted to be. Or discover the player.
It's hard when you're a professional, a musician, not to take the party to a level. I'm glad that we kind of figured out how to keep everything really balanced and really just focus on the music. I'm excited about where that's gonna go.
We've been fairly professional on some days, and some days we get nothing done. But when we recognize that we're like getting it done, everybody kind of gets on it, and we get a lot more done than I remembered. You know what I mean? Like, you walk away, you're like, oh, we got one or two done today, and then you listen back, and you're like, all right, we got like six or seven done today. And not done, but...
started.
Yeah, exactly. Like, every recording we make is going to be recorded 40 times. You know, unless we magically get that beautiful, perfect take, no background noise, and, you know. Mainly that every time we record, the pressure's not there to make it like anything special. It's really just like moving forward, like keep recording until you get, you know, a solid final product. Or... So I don't know where I want this to go. Like, I really don't, but I like where it's going, honestly. You know what I mean?
Be a good day, it was.
Oh, racing back. Yeah. Okay, so.
Don't come racing back to Sulphur. Once you left, it faded all to gray. It looked a lot like heaven when I held you. Honestly, old brimstone every day.
I think that. Am I singing on the song?
I want you to be harmony. I think Charlie should play guitar. I should sing it because it's smarmier. I think I have a better smarmy voice than you. Plus, I'm a girl.
I've never heard anybody say that in my entire life.
Gaff tape.
I think that when you repeat
it.
What is it?
The held you?
Yeah, it's kind of, I don't know
just
about that.
Just me and you. Say, we'll all say, how have you? And
how
just me and her will say, how have you?
So how do we want to do this? How are we going to sing this?
I don't know. I like it. I like singing it, but I also
like singing it.
What if y'all did it in rounds?